Okay, guys.
Welcome back to Casa Cozy, finally, again.
Yeah, bathroom time now.
Yes. We've been working on the bathroom for a very, very long time, but now we're finally done.
Yeah, and we didn't show so much in between, like every little step, because we wanted to do the whole result as a whole in one shot, and yeah.
Yeah. Well, when we moved in here, the bathroom was very, very different from now. It was... It had white tiles everywhere, it had a bathtub. It was not very cozy. So we took all the tiles down and then we just built it new. We made new walls and everything, we'll show you. We put micro cement everywhere, made a shower. So yeah, very excited to show
you. Quite a big change.
The outside of the bathroom, the walls are not done yet, as you can see, but we are almost there. This is a door that Clemens built out of our old door that was here, I think. Made it a double swing door. And now, ready for the bathroom? Let's see. So this is the result. This is how the bathroom is now. It's a big difference, as you can see. And we are very, very happy with it. I think it turned out really nice, very cozy. Exactly how we wanted it to be. We also had like a double ceiling before, which we took away, and now we have a much higher ceiling, which we like, so we can have this beautiful lamp, get nice shadows, much cozier. We of course have more light in here. This is just like the cozy lamp, and then we have over the mirror.
Yeah, lots of details to talk about, but before we go into the bathroom, the doors were one quite big project that we did all by ourselves. And they turned out quite nice, a little bit proud, because at first I thought we are never going to be able to make these doors by ourselves with all the straight cuts and that everything fits and works well, because I mean door is, you know, quite advanced project. But we cut open this, used to be one door, we cut it open in the middle and fit both both sides into the frame. And of course, this 100-year-old door gets very unstable because we had to cut it very slim. So we added these metal bands on the sides, on both sides, and also on the top around. I've bent this around on the bottom as well, so that every wing, every side of the door is completely stable and will never fall apart. Yes, then the next step was to find hinges. So we got these and they work really well. I really like them. So then another thing about door, which I was a bit scared about, is of course a frame and the mechanism so the door is really tight. So we put in this door frame a little strip here, painted this white. So when the door closes, it sits against this frame and is closed. The same we did in the middle, we put on these strips on the inside and on the outside so that the middle gap is covered. For the closure, we just went with a simple like a terrace snapper, which you have, one is up there, one is on the bottom, spring loaded, so it snaps onto that metal piece and the door stays closed. When we opened the ceiling, we cut in this hole for a big window to get a little bit more natural light into this bathroom, at least. And the glass is ordered, it takes a while, but when that's there, we will make a window frame, put that in. It's gonna be nice.
Okay, now let's look into the bathroom.
Cool.
First thing we wanna talk about is the micro cement. So as you can see, in the whole bathroom, we have the same micro cement from Calament that we used in the kitchen, everywhere. It's the color 60. It is quite light, but it's perfect in here since we don't have so much natural light, so it makes it a bit brighter. It was a bit more tricky to make this than the kitchen because it's of course much more, but we did it in 3 days only or something, so it was quite good. And I'm super happy with the result. So the micro cement, if you don't know what it is like a very, very thin layer, 2 millimeter layer of some kind of a cement plaster that you can easily put on almost anything, and it's super durable, it's water resistant, and it's just perfect to use if you want to do a seamless concrete bathroom or kitchen or whatever you want to do. So we have it in the shower, we have it on the floor, and it's really, really durable. It's really good, so I recommend it if you want to do a concrete bathroom. So another big difference that we made in the bathroom is that we built this extra wall here. Because before we had a toilet here also, but there was this box that went in. But to not have that and to also be able to make these boxes, we just made the whole wall all over. So we could make these too. And then, since we had a bathtub here before that we took away, we wanted to make a shower, but we also had all the tubes under, so we could not make the shower much lower. That's why it's so high up. But we think it looks actually great. We made the little tiles here that we put, cement tiles from Mosaic Factory. In the beginning we were supposed to have a glass wall here with a little opening in the middle so that the water wouldn't come out, but we didn't get the glass wall yet. We haven't ordered it yet because it was really tricky to find some custom-made glass wall. So our solution was to put a shower curtain for now, and this one is like a really beautiful fabric curtain but with acrylic inside, so it doesn't look so plasticky.
I really like it.
Yeah,
also,
we like it.
Also gives some more organic
exactly
touch to
it's
the...
a bit softer in here with this. Maybe with the glass wall it will be too also claustrophobic, so we will see now how it works. Maybe we will have a glass wall in the future, but for now this is the best solution and we kind of like it.
Okay, one other project we did is this bathroom table that we put together from the wood that we also used for the table in the dining room. And this table obviously is to hold our beautiful sink from Vallone. Also the tap and the handle, all from Vallone. They really bring together this bathroom. It's the black Nero series. And we also have that in the shower. One is for the rain shower up on top. The other handle for the hand shower. I really love this symmetry with the box that Jax made. And the black just fits really well together with the concrete. And of course the star tiles. Yes, very, very happy with that. The toilet is from Vallone.
Hello.
And the other important detail in the bathroom is of course good light. So we have these three spots here, LED spots from Beaver and the Crane. So let's put that on.
Another thing I want to show you that I'm very excited about is the new towels that we have from See You Soon. I don't know if you know, but we have always for years been using their beach towels. And now they just made their Casa collection. So they are making towels for home. And these are some of them. These are the storm color, like charcoal. They are garment dyed in cotton and they're super, super beautiful from Greece. And one more thing. One thing that really makes the bathroom extra, extra cozy is of course the lamp from Colore Locale. We were trying around different lamps having here to see the different shadows, but I think this one is just the best. I love the little shadows coming everywhere. It makes it really, really cozy. So yeah.
Of course we have, like everywhere in Casa Cozy, a dimmer also for this lamp, so you can actually at night dim this down to your desired lightness and it gets very, very cozy in here. This was the bathroom.
Yes, and we're super happy with the result. It fits really well with the kitchen and everything else we built. So next step to build is...
stairs.
Yes, the stairs. We decided to do it ourselves in the end because it was just... too much with the steel stair and
yes.
But yeah, we're gonna talk about that later.
Exactly.
But anyway, so we're gonna show you some more footage of the bathroom and then you can see more details on the blog post.
Absolutely.
Bye!
See you soon!
Bye.